intent can be difficult to prove. Back when I was still a kid and not quite turned 71, I frequented senior centers from Maine to California. I could still see well enough to drive back then, and could hear well enough to tell time. At one of the centers, I remember, I had always dined opposite Louise. An interesting enough oldster, who always seemed to be $5 shy of purchasing some service or repair or upgrade she presently needed. My first impression was that she reminded me of a fellow hack back in the 1970s by the name of Louie, who was kind of a larcenist. Louie would ask fellow cabbies, "Do you have 5 ones?" with the intent of distracting them into forgetting to take his $5 bill. And of this, he was proud, because he knew that intent can be difficult to prove. Well, one day Louise did not come to lunch, so I sat with other seniors, one of whom took to criticizing her for her tight-fistedness. "She's too cheap to buy a hearing aid," was one example. While it is not a crime to criticize one's fellow senior, I did silently contrast this behavior with that of Louise herself, who never had an unkind word for anyone. And somehow I felt the timing of this criticism was made for my ears in particular. I was forever speaking loud enough for the whole dining room to hear me, because Louise was pretty deaf much of the time. After that day, and in my necessary loud volume, I made it a point to sympathize with Louise on her every $5 dilemma. On this particular day, it was the up-and-coming Saturday night Frank and Beans with cornbread and milk and apple pie and ice cream. Louise, as good an eater as a growing youngster, said, "Where is one on a fixed income to come by $5 for that?" She did not even have $1 for today's raffle. But she did happen to have just 50 cents. But the setup was that you had to buy 2 tickets at one time for $1. Did I by chance have 50 cents I could spare for one of the 2 tickets? I sure did, and when she came back with them, she held them up to me and said, "Which ticket do you want?" I took the one from her left hand, I remember, saying to myself, "I guess we are not going in this together." Not consciously thinking through the potential for larceny in her little ambiguity, But then, wouldn't you know it, they called my number. I let out a whoo. Woohoo! And collected my prize money. How much? Said Louise. I counted then what turned out to be 10 $1 bills and began putting them in my pocket when Louise let out the dead-waking scream. We had an agreement! Needless to say, I slapped 5 of the ones in her palm before the others even exhaled. Intent can be difficult to prove. The day I left town, I remember, and for another senior center, no doubt, I said goodbye to almost all with whom I had made acquaintance that month. Except for Louise, who had, I discovered, already boarded the senior van. I rushed out just as the driver was loading her walker. I boarded, skirting her one time unkind, you remember, critic, and hugged Louise a forever goodbye.